elephants in Africa, you know, are under threat. Populations have declined by 30%, and that's mainly Central and East Africa. The situation in Southern Africa is different.
Despite their enormous size and their giant ears and the long trunk and how they use those tusks to get even the highest leaves on the trees and their toenails that you can sometimes see in the tracks, it was just quite a unique animal.
On Salati, being 28,500 hectares, we have a population of elephants that we believe are approaching carrying capacity, and we take advice from the ecologists who tell us that our numbers are becoming such that they're affecting biodiversity on the property.
Elephants are classified as a keystone species. So what that means, they have a disproportionate effect on most of the living systems around them.
Twice a year, the research team do a elephant impact assessment, counting over 1,000 trees, over 40 sites across the reserve.
They will push over trees, you know, they will damage trees, the grass will go, with the grass, you know, your normal plains game will go, therefore your predators go, and that eventually have a massive effect on the entire ecosystem. We will do an elephant immunocontraception on this reserve next month.
We've looked at various options. Right now at the moment, there's very few places that can take elephants, and you can't transport elephants too far either.
A vasectomies of bulls, that's exceedingly expensive. It's extremely invasive, and therefore the reserve and us have decided together that, you know, rather to do immunocontraception.
Funding is incredibly important for the elephant contraception. We want to make sure on Salati, one of our main goals is to create a sustainable ecological system.
The Salati Wilderness Foundation was set up with three pillars in mind: community engagement, security, and in research and wildlife management.
For the first phase, we're looking for around about 300,000 rand to cover the costs by the NPC, and in subsequent years it'll be less than that.
Saving the Survivors have generously donated Dr. Johan Murray's time, but we still need to pay for helicopter hours, all the immunocontraception drug, the darts, and all the manpower on the day.
We have a diminishing free and wild places in Africa today. The entire ecosystems where we can go to and experience, you know, nature like this. So it's exceedingly important to look after an ecosystem like this, because we've put fences around here, like most reserves in Africa. And unfortunately, we do not want to do it, but we have to do immunocontraception on the elephants to basically, in the end, protect the soil, which will then protect the entire ecosystem around it.